First on my agenda this morning is to actually control fleas on good old Gizzy here. We've been shearing them for the time that they've even been alive. Like, we thought, well, the quick and easiest way to get rid of fleas off our boys is to actually shear them. We don't use no flea controls or anything like that. We have got a harness where they usually come outside. We clip him on by the harness. As you can see, he's quite calm. He's really used to it. We do take the harness off to do any shearing. It's about a half an hour to do one cat for me to do. When June's out of here, it's sometimes a little bit quicker. But yeah, he's going to feel very cold after. So I'll put him inside with the heater and let him warm up, because it's a little bit chilly this morning. I reckon it's probably only about 7 degrees here at the moment, Celsius. So you ready, Gizzy? Hey, you ready, mate? Come on, off with the collar. I'm using a one blade, Mark II speed, whale machine. That way it doesn't cut it too far down on the fur. Come on, hop up. That's a boy. Get up. Hop up. Go down and do your harness, mate. Hop up. You know what's going on, don't you? Come here. You're not going to run away. Don't be a data this morning. Come here. Off the bum. Take it off the bum. Take it off. That's a boy. Put the harness up there. Now I start with the face first because it's always the hardest. So I'll just turn him around this way. I don't have it on the fastest speed because the blade heats up too much. He can see the machine now that I've turned around. He knows what's going on. I always hold by the elbow. I used to shear in the younger years. So you definitely got to hold the ears. I do the face and all. He is a long-haired Persian. So we try to keep it. See, there's a flea there. So that's going to keep them down. We can't see them to actually get the fleas off. So even if you do flea control, they still have fleas. That's what we've found. Cats are a bit different to sheep, I know. But at least a cat is a bit more placid to hang on to. Especially once you've been doing it for many years. I don't do around the eyes, because the fur can actually land in your eye. If I can possibly help it anyway. Our first sign of when they've got fleas is they start scratching. So that's usually the time we start shearing them. It's usually every 3 to 6 months. The mice play come through, and that's what's actually brought the fleas along, so we're trying to keep it nice and short for them. Just going to pluck that one off. Don't like the little buggers. He's really in depth into that. Yeah, he's right into that. I can't get that. I've got no fingernails, so I'll squash him to death. No. There we go. Get that little bugger off. He's no longer resisting. So that's one down. Now get really deep into his fur, because he's got real dense fur. Thank you. I know there's probably better methods of keeping fleas out. They've been doing this for a long time. We had two black cats. We used to do those, but they died, not from being shorn. Someone took them and they killed them. So yeah, we love our boys at the moment. The other two were a female. We were camped up somewhere, and I won't say where. And they were outside, and they were gone. Chin up, mate. That's a boy. There's another one. So yeah. Chin up. Chin's almost done. Two more. The easy part about having no fur on them, well, they still have a little bit of fur, but it doesn't go right down to the skin, is that we can find the fleas quicker. We can pluck them off with a pair of tweezers and they're gone. Keeps the fleas down a lot easier. More manageable for us. Yes, I know it's cold, mate. Come on, up you come. Up you. I do pull the skin a fair bit to flatten it out so I don't cut the skin. As you can see, he's quite calm. He's actually shivering at the moment. You can feel the cold. This is only the quarter of the length of what his fur usually gets to. They all do not like their tail touched doing this, but I'll get there with it. Yes, I know it's cold, mate. Won't be long. We find usually the fleas are up around the neck, but it's much easier to do the whole body. Less chance of them going down to the tail, because sometimes they creep in around the tail there. Just from experience of what we've found with our boys. What, mate? Yeah, you can look at me. You'll come crawling back to me later. Down this side now. Hang on, stay here. Thank you. Fleas don't like the cold either. So, a bit like mice in a way, mice don't like cold. They die out. We do have them after we do this. Our boys come and climb in the bed after we've done all of the shearing overnight time because it gets cold. We've got a diesel heater in our van. Keeps us nice and warm overnight time. You're going to have to roll over, mate. You're going to have to roll over or stand up or do something. Just leave your tail. Pretty good today with his tail. Yeah, let's see so as soon as we finish now. Yes, I know it's cold. Give me the tail. Little bugger. Hang on, sit down. Like a little snake tail. Pretty good there. Alright, where are we up to? Just a look, mate. Stand up. Want to stand up? Hop up. And get the fur out of your road. Out of my road. Stay there. Stay there. Yeah. Almost finished, mate. Almost done. Want to turn around? No, we're not getting on my shoulder. Yes, I know it's cold. Come over here. Roll over. Come on. Roll over. I know the back of the ute is cold. Roll over. Come on, roll over. Roll over. Roll over, that's a boy. Stay there. Stay there. Stay there. No, you're not going to hang on to the side of the ute, you little bugger. I'm going to spin you around so you can't do that. Come on, lay down. He's contesting with me at the moment, so I'm going to do it a little bit different. Hang on to him like a little baby. No. Alright. Oh, what? Well, I like that then. I know you don't like laying on your back. Stay there. Oh, you like that. I know it's cold. I can't help that. Blame the weather. Thank you. We're having issues here, mate. Just hang on a minute. Let's pull the blade apart. It's clogged up. This is the only one I've got. So I've got to persevere, clean it out. I have got a 4, but it's a lot finer. Get closer down to the skin. I don't want to do that at the moment. Sounds like the other boys are having fun inside. Stay there.
Stay there.
That's better. Look up. No. Come on. Try something different, eh? Try something different. We go down this way, eh? Yes, I know. Come on. First time I started doing this, it took me an hour and a half. So it was a little of a learning curve when I started. To do a cat, that was. You know, sheep are so quick. Cats, they move around a bit. They're trying to get every little bit. It's not easy. The skin rolls a lot more down. Put the foot down. Get rid of those bad boys, eh? Can you come back over here? Coming away. Now, where am I up to, mate? I can't see what I'm doing here. I'm moving around too much. You're gonna have to roll over on your side. Yeah. Linda. Come on, over on your side. Oh, it's enough. Lie down. that in. Hey there. Not too worried on how clean it is, as long as we've got most of it off so we can see the fleas. Head down. Now, have a break, eh? Not doing too bad, am I, mate, eh? Just about there, got to stop that from blowing away, though. How about we carry you away? We'll come back to you in a minute. I've had to go and get reinforcements, so I went and got June, just to give me a hand. Seems it is a little bit cold this morning for Gizzy. Bring your bum back here. I've cleaned up all the fur too. No. Not at the moment. Then roll over, Gizzy. What? Run the tune. That's a big sucker. Right, I'll do his undercarriage. Hold that forward. Stay there. Don't hamstring you, mate. It's enough. Keep your leg out. Thank you, mate. Didn't fall. Didn't fall. Clean up. Oh, damn, now that is real skinny. There. Up you go. Up you go. By all means, I'm no professional at doing this, but I just get the job done. Take your head around that way, please. Guess it takes, sometimes does take two of us to do this. But we love our boys. Their health and well-being is best. So these blood-sucking parasites. Sometimes we go places where you've got ticks. And if you've got a tick underneath a fur, you can't see it. Just hold him in the front. He's not that off me.
He's sneaking to mum.
Right, I want to turn him around, please.
Okay. Which way? There's your way?
Yep. Right, and you're going to come up this end, and I'm going down that end. So I can do this side. Come on, up with your bum. Up your bum. I can't see it, so I might have to ride him on his back, on his side. Oh yeah. Let his leash go. It looks like he's grabbing onto him in there. Because he's not going to run away. Come on.
I know, mate. Come on, roll over. Yes, I know. Come on. Come on. There you go. Head down.
Yeah, stay like that for a second. Those squeezes, please. These are mouths and they're dripping, mate. What's this one? Just a little bit, like so. I've only got that four to go and that's it.
What's that one?
Just four. Oh yeah, that'll do you, mate. Yep, that'll do you.
Stand up.
I'll get that little bit on his chest there, up here. That'll do. No one's going to look at you. Sniffer going to a beauty parlour, mate. Yeah, sniffer going to a beauty parlour, we'll put your harness back on. Hey? Come here. There you go. Give you a blow. Get rid of the munners.
You hold his finger in it, please.
I'll do better. I'll put his harness on. Yeah, one arm. I call that an arm. That's it. You're not going anywhere. Alright, and that is Gizzy done. Harness on, collar on, just adjust it all up. He's flea-less. We can actually see them now and control them ourselves. Because with it being coming on to winter,
we're in winter.
Oh, are we? Oh, yep. Yeah, okay. We try to keep them inside as much as possible, our boys, because of the cold.
They're not an outdoor cat.
They're indoor, outdoor, but with this mice plague that we've had, we've tried to keep them indoors as much as possible. There you go. Hey? You're a good boy, aren't you? Alright. On to the next one. So if you like this video of Gizzy being Sean, his actual name is Gizmo, please like, subscribe, give us a thumbs up or a thumbs down. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video.